Dear participants from all over the world, we would like to welcome you to our today's web seminar, Quick Solutions with eTools for Linear Guides and Screwdrives from Rexroth's Business Unit Linear Motion Technology. My name is Frank Warmuth. Next to me is my colleague Gerhard Schwab. Today we want to bring you by an application example the possibilities which you have to easily and quickly select our product based on your application needs, and this is supported by our eTool toolchain. This will be a live presentation, and we have different functions for interaction in the session. Please find in the lower area of your window a chat functionality, a chat window. Feel free to type in your questions there whenever they appear, and we will come to them directly in the session, and as well have a chance to have additional questions and answers after the main part of the web seminar. We also prepared some voting questions for you. They will appear in the lower right area of the screen. And yeah, please give us our feedback to the questions we raise to get in more interaction with you. And as a last information about the technology here, you have the chance to extend or expand all the windows on your screen. So if you want to have a deeper look in the drawings or in the special windows, you can open or expand each window with the icons on the upper right edge. But yeah, we are here currently, of course, we're dealing with the Corona situation we still have here. So we take special measures like testing, and also have a wall between us as presenters today. So no deal about security issues. The web seminar will be recorded, and we will provide it afterwards to you and other interests as well. But of course, the chat will be anonymized. So far the beginning. Gerhard, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, thanks, Frank. My name is Gerhard Schwab. I work in the product management for profile trail systems. I'm looking forward to our web seminar, and we want to involve you as participant directly in our web seminar, and therefore we prepared questions about your function in your incorporation. Do you work as an application engineer, as a design engineer, as a dealer, or in other function? Please answer the questions in our chat. I see most of you work as a design engineer, but also other functions are represented. We hope we can get you valuable information via our web seminar, and we start now.
Yeah, let's start. Start with your requirements. So, how we understand your requirements is displayed here, but please also feel free to add additional requirements now live in the chat window. So to select a product, your requirement is to have a quick application-based product selection, because the application you want to solve is the base of all the doings. Besides the selection, you want to have a documentation for the selection process itself, as well as for the product, which is then selected in the end. Besides the documentation, CAD data is essential for its integration of the product in your environment, engineering environment. And besides this functional aspects, the availability is crucial. So 24/7 is a need to find easily and quickly the products based on your needs whenever you need it. Price and delivery are important aspects, besides all the technical solution process, and also the chance to have an easy and direct ordering is another relevant aspect.
What is your time estimation? How long does it take for the whole process for linear guides and also for screw assemblies? Do you estimate it takes 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, or 120 minutes? We put this question in the chat. Please answer it. I Now we got the answers. Most of you estimate that it takes 10 minutes or more. And now we will show you how easy and how fast it works with the eTools of Bosch Rexroth. The whole process contains of 5 steps. In the application description, we define the dynamics, the masses, and also the forces. Based on this information, we make the product selection and the product recommendation. And when we go to the configurators, we define these products completely. And for these complete defined products, you can get information like delivery time and also price. And you can make the ordering process by yourself independently. Therefore, we linked our eTools of Bosch Rexroth, the calculation program, linear motion designer, the configurators, and also our webshop.
Gerhard, is it necessary to transfer the data from one tool to the next by hand?
No, it's you have only to put in this, the same data one time, saving time and saving money.
Oh, that's great. But let's prove it with an example application we prepared for the session today. So imagine you have to solve a pressing process. And here on the right side, you can see the machine for this example. So we have a pressing tool. And here on the left side, shown in blue, the linear guides, as well as in green marked the area where we assume to have a screw drive. You can also find additional dimensions here on the right screen. The top view, where again here in blue, the profile rails are already sketched, as well as the screw drive in green below. And besides the basic geometrical design, we talk about dynamics we have to solve. So we have 3 phases there. The first phase is a rapid traverse with a proportional time of 25% with a speed of 0.25 meters per second. The second phase is a pressing phase with 10% in time with a velocity of 0.05 meters per second. And the third phase is a dwell time. So for changing the parts, it's 65% in this example and standstill. We have to move a mass of 250 kilograms as a tool and have a pressing force assumed here of 30,000 newtons. So based on this application, let's give the challenge to Gerhard to find a solution.
Okay, thanks, Frank. We now start with the calculation program, Linear Motion Designer. You can download it from our website. At the end of the web seminar, I will give you additional information for it. First, a few words about the structure of the software. You can generate files, you can load existing files, and you can also save files, and you can change the language. It's German available, English, Spanish, French, Chinese, and also Italian. Additional is a calculation planning guide contained in which you can read about backgrounds more. You make the selection with the linear motion designer. You can calculate profiled rail systems. You can calculate linear bushings and also screw assembly. The selection is done by clicking. In our example, we have profiled rail systems. We have a screw assembly. You activate it by clicking. Then we go to the next mask. With the linear motion designer, you can calculate from one guide rail, one runner block, up to 2 guide rails and 8 runner blocks.
So as you see here, we have a wide range of choices, 6 choices, but what should I use as a default when I'm not sure? How should I start?
Okay. Very often is used 2 guide rails and 4 runner blocks. The big advantage is that existing moments are converted into forces, and this leads to smaller loads for the runner blocks. In our example, we also take this two guide rails and four runner blocks. In the next mask, we put in the system dimension for the profiled rail systems. Here you see for the drive a sketch, here's a zero point, and also a coordinate system is integrated. We put in the position of the drive in Z direction, minus 100. And then you see the position is showed, displayed schematically, it changed. The next input, we make the sender-sender distance of the runner blocks to each other. And you also see that this dimension is red lighted in the sketch above. These are 450. Next, we go to the guide rail sender-sender distance. And you see also this dimension is red lighted in the sketch. These are also 450 millimeters. With the linear motion designer, it's possible to change the arrangement of the axis via the rotation angle alpha. It's around the x-axis, and the rotation angle beta, it's around the y-axis. In our case, we have here 270 degrees. And when we put it, this value, the application is displayed rotated. Then we go next to the system dimension of the screw assembly. The first selection is the bearing of the spindle. In the calculation program, all kinds of bearings are integrated, started with fixed floating up to fixed free. And when we change, for example, to fixed free, the sketch is changed also.
Gerhard, again here, a question for our participants. Yeah. We have a handful of choices here. Mm-hmm. What would you recommend as a starting point?
Yes. Approximately 90% or more have the spindle bearing fixed floating, and we take this spindle bearing also for our application. The next selection is the lead of the screw. In the pull-down menu, all possible leads are listed. And the choice of the lead depends on two influencing factors. One is when you have a larger lead, it enables a higher speed, but also it requires a higher motor moment. So the selection is depending on these two influencing factors. We take in our example 10 millimeters. The bearing center to distance, we take 600 millimeters. The rotation angle is defined already. Then we go to the next input mask. It's the input mask for dynamics. For dynamics, you have different possibilities. The first one is to take a dynamic cycle. Also, it's possible to take part of time or percentage of stroke. For all these different kinds, up to 18 phases are possible. Additionally, you can select motion profiles, and it's possible to put in only two values and selection motion profile to make the input of the dynamics. In our case, we take part of time, and we have three phases. The first one has 25%. It's a rapid traverse. The speed are 0.25. Acceleration, we simplify and take zero. The next phase is a pressing phase with 10%. Speed is 0.05. Acceleration also zero. And the last one is a dwell time with 65% and zero. The speed is zero and also the acceleration. Then we go to the next inputs. We start here in this input mask with the masses. Up to 9 masses are possible. We have in our example 1 mass. It's possible to increase the size of the sketch here by clicking. And in this sketch, there is a coordinate system and also the zero point. In our example, we have
150 kilogram.
Frank, please go to the slide with the application to make it easier for the participants to see it.
And it's the mass of our axis, and the coordinates of the mass is 0 in x direction, 0 in y direction, and z direction are 250 millimeters. Now we can decrease the size.
Gerhard, might I interrupt you? The question in the chat is, what is when the requirements change in the course of the project? So maybe a dimension is changed due to other circumstances.
It's also possible to change the dimension. Here it's possible with the settings. Due to time reasons, I don't go deeper in this, but it's possible to change to different units.
Okay, so this is a unit aspect, and if maybe the dimension now set changes from 250 to 200 millimeters?
It's no problem. You can save your file, and you can load it again, and you can change it.
Thank you.
And the masses here, you see, are activated, but it's possible to deactivate them by clicking and also to reactivate again.
Yeah, what about the accelerations users can enter here on the bottom of the screen? Yeah. When should they use them?
With the trans acceleration, it is possible to calculate a multi-axis application also with the linear designer. The next input after the masses are the forces. Up to 12 forces are possible. We have one force. Also possible to increase the size of the sketch. We have in x direction minus 30,000. The x direction are 600, y direction 0, and z direction 300. Now I decrease the size. And you have to activate it here by clicking. And the force is active in phase 2. In tips, you can read more about the calculation assumptions. Next, I go to the selection of the profiled rail systems. Here is a selection guide integrated, and it makes very easily for user to select the runner block types. We go deeper in. First, you make a choice, a selection of the industry. We have a forming process. So we go to forming technology here. And our application is a push-in process. And you see, you get a recommendation for the usable runner block type. It's also possible to change this recommendation. For example, when you have enough space in your application, you can take a long version of the runner block. And you see, then the runner block type is changed when I make the selection with the long runner block type. When you go to take over, you have the complete product selection done. And starting with the smallest size, all possible sizes are listed. When I click one part number, you see on the right side the results of the calculation. You see here the dynamic load for the different runner blocks. Here is a safety check for all faces and runner blocks. And below, there are the results of the lifetime for the most heavily loaded runner block. Here is a lifetime in kilometer, and here is a lifetime in hours.
Yeah, the often raised question is about lubrication of the products. Does the tool also assist there somehow?
Yes, it's a very useful, valuable information, and we integrated lubrication also in the linear motion designer. You click here, and it's very easy. You make a selection of the lubricant, for example, grease, and then you see you get the information about the interval, the lubrication interval, and also about the quantity of the lubricant.
Yeah, that sounds quite helpful, yeah?
Yeah. Then we go to the next step. It's a selection of the screw assembly. First, when we go here in deeper, you have to select which element is driven. In our case, we take a screw is driven. Next is a selection of the type of screw assembly. You have the possibility to choose between a standard ball screw assembly and a standard planetary screw assembly.
Yeah, the participants in the session might not be aware between the difference between the both choices. Mm-hmm. When should they use which one?
Yes. A general rule is when a high performance density is required, please take the planetary screw assembly. The ball screw assembly has an advantage when you have higher dynamics, and we have a very big variety of ball screw assemblies in our product portfolio. In our case, we have high loads and not too much place, so we take the planetary screw assembly. And you also get more information about this product in our website, where you can read in detail about the dimensions, for example, and the advantages of the different solutions. Next selection is a type of nut. The abbreviation is the first one is for flange nut, and the next one is for cylindric nut. We take in our case a flange nut because of the good connection to the construction. You see the next criteria are underlined. That means when you click with the left mouse button on this criteria, you get additional information. For example, the tolerance class is the information about the lead deviation at 300 millimeter screw length. First, we have to select the tolerance classes and the preload.
Could you give a hint based on our example application? What should customer choose now? When to use a better or lower tolerance class or even a preload? Mm-hmm.
Good, Frank. The rule is if the application requires a high accuracy, you should select a very good tolerance class and a high preload. In our example, the accuracy is not so demanding, so we take T7, and we take preload without preload. And the next one is the ceiling, and we have standard conditions. So a wiper, it's enough. Then you make the click on the show selection, and you see, starting with the smallest diameter, all the possible diameters are listed. When I click in, you also see the results of the lifetime for the screw and the spindle system.
Yeah, I think this is quite comprehensive information. But now we always talked about the spindle and the nut on it. Mm-hmm. What about the bearing?
Yes, bearing is also very important. And we don't only want to check the nut and the spindle. We also want to check the bearings. And so we integrated the function unit and bearing here in the calculation program. First, you make a selection of the bearing assembly. And you see for the first suggestion, you get a warning message. In this case, the load capacity is a lot of lower than the nut of the nut. And so you get a reduced lifetime for the complete system. You go to the unit. For these abbreviations, there are also more information in our website catalog where you can read about the details. We make a change, we take another one, and you see there's no warning message any longer. We have a high load capacity for this bearing, and with the selection of the bearing, also the spindle end forms and versions are defined. Then we have finished the selection of the products, and we go to the product mask of the linear motion designer here. And here in the project, a mask of the linear motion designer, you can get a lot of more additional information for the selected products.
What kind of information can you get, Sergei? Could you go a bit more in detail?
Yes, Frank. When you go, for example, to documentation, you can save a printout. You define a name and then you save it. And then the printout file is saved and also the calculation file is saved. And in the printout are all information contained which we put in the linear motion designer. Due to time reasons, I don't go deeper in the printout. Another possibility to save the file is when you go to the save function, then only the calculations file is saved.
Thanks, Gerhard. Yeah. Meanwhile, an additional question appeared in the chat. Does the software always check the values I put in, or is there a room for mistakes?
You see, normally you get a lot of optical helps, for example, when you put in the system dimensions. And when you, for example, make a product selection and something is wrong, you get a warning message. So you have always support for the user.
Thanks, Gerhard. And yeah, for the participants, feel free to add additional questions in the chat and we will follow up on them. Yeah, now we have finished the whole technical selection process in the tool. What about additional data which was on the requirements list, like the CAD model?
Yes, right. One further information, when you go here, for example, on the online catalog, you go to the specific websites for the selected products. And with CAD, when you click the CAD button, you jump to the configurators. Click it here.
So I see a browser opening and yes. Two tabs appearing.
Two tabs are appearing. We have to wait a second. Oh, yeah, I think it's a presenter effect. I have to close it. Something doesn't work.
So life is life.
Life is life. So we do it again.
But, no manual entering of transfer of data is necessary, yeah?
Okay. And now it works, you see. It's a live demonstration. First, we go into the configurator of the profiled rail systems in the runner block configurator. This product is completely defined. You see here, you have the material number, and it's not necessary to put in additional information for this runner block. You get the information about the attributes of the product when you go to the product description. Here you see, and all attributes are listed here of the selected runner block. I close it. Next one, when you need CAD files, you go to the request CAD button. And then you go to options. You can select the needed format, for example, IGES, apply. And here you put in your email address and click the request button. Then you get a reply email. And in the reply email, there is a link contained where you can download these CAD files.
Yeah. Sounds great, and I think with this, the package of technical information is complete for the user. But open questions are still about pricing and availability. Yes. Do we address this?
Yes. When you contact our sales, you get access to our web shop. And when you have this access, you make a login here. And then you have only to put in this product in the shopping cart. And then you get the required information like delivery time and also the price. And you can also do the ordering process by yourself independently. Then with the runner block configurator, I have shown, I think, everything. Then I go now to the screw assembly configurator. for this screw assembly, we have to add additional information, for example, about the lubrication. We make a selection, then we go forward. The next one is about the centering of the left side. We take without centering here. Then we have to also put in this information for the right spindle end. We take also none. And then we have only to select the documentation. We take a standard report, for example. And then it's finished. You see, we have the complete product description of this screw assembly with a lot of information like the spindle end forms and the spindle version. And you also get CAD files here. And you can also go to the web shop when you put this product in the shopping cart. So we have finished. We have all information. And we have done the complete job.
Yeah, and when I check the time, now around about 30 minutes have passed since the beginning of this web seminar at all, and we ask the question, how long do you think the sizing takes in selecting the right products for an example application? And yeah, we had a majority of somehow between 10 to 30 minutes. I think it's feasible to do it if you're really fast in 15 minutes, but with the explanations here, we took a little longer. But now, after showing all this functionality, a question appears right now in the chat. Where can I find more information about the linear motion designer, or where can the participants even download it now?
Yeah, we go to the next slide. And in the slide, it's a link integrated where you can get the software. You will get this documentation after the web seminar. And you get it on free. It's free for you. And you can also get the Lean Select. That is another calculation tool, which is suitable for linear access and actuators. And please use the software and save time and save money. And you can install the software without administration rights. You can do it by yourself when you have downloaded the software.
So thanks, Gerhard, for this impressive demonstration, how really quickly and easily you can select a linear motion technology product. As you said, we will send out a mail package afterwards, and you can download also or view this recorded web seminar, which we will provide in the next days on our online channels. Thanks for taking part in this web seminar. We would like to ask you to vote for the last few questions. Would get feedback about this web seminar. Was it helpful for you? Please share your ideas here with us in this last voting. And again, thanks for your participation, and download the Linear Motion Designer now and check it and test it for your first applications you have to solve. Thank you and goodbye.